Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
SlideMaster View is a special feature in PowerPoint that allows you to modify all the slides in your presentation by only making changes to one main slide, the SlideMaster. This can be a great time saver because you can make changes to your entire presentation without having to edit each slide individually. Right now, I'm working on a presentation for a pasta company, and I'd like to add their logo to every slide. Manually adding the image to each slide would not only be time-consuming, but it would also be harder to get the image aligned the exact same way on each slide. The SlideMaster is going to make this a lot easier. I'll start by going to the View tab, and then clicking the SlideMaster command. The SlideMaster view may look a little different from the other views you've used, but don't worry, it's not hard to use. A pane will open on the left. Scroll to the top. Here we have the SlideMaster, and beneath it are the layout slides. Let's try inserting our logo. Select the SlideMaster. You can insert a shape or picture here just like you normally would. Just go to the Insert tab and click the Pictures command. Select your image, and then click Insert. Then just move or resize the picture if you need to. Now this image is going to be in the same location on every slide. While I'm here, I think I'd also like to give the title a new font, so it stands out a little bit from the rest of the text on the slide. I can edit the title font for each slide by selecting the text here, and then just choosing a new font like I normally would. Let's close the SlideMaster view for a second and see how our image looks on the other slides. Well, the logo looks good, and it's in the upper left corner on each slide, but it looks like we've got two problems here. On my title slide, the logo doesn't show up at all. Also, this shape is covering the logo on some of the slides. And on others, it's too far down. It's okay though, we can fix all of these things by going back to the SlideMaster view. Let's start with the slide where our logo isn't showing up. Beneath the master slide are the layout slides. Each of these represents one of the possible layouts we can use in this presentation. The first slide is the title slide layout. When we hover over it, we can see which slides in the presentation are using this layout. Select it, and now any changes we make here will be reflected on slide 1. So why didn't our logo show up on this slide? Well, with some layouts, the background graphics may be hidden. To show the graphics, all we need to do is uncheck the Hide Background Graphics box here. And our logo has reappeared, along with the other background graphics. Now let's fix the shape that's covering our logo. Most of our slides aren't using any of these layouts, so we won't bother with those. But here we can see that several of our slides are using this layout, so this is the one we want to make changes to. Just select it, and I'm just going to move the shape down a little. If you want, you can also move, resize, or delete any of the placeholders in this view. I'm going to move this placeholder a little bit so it's aligned with the arrow. And then I'm just going to resize this placeholder. Then just adjust any of the other layout slides if you need to. Let's try editing another layout slide. The title and caption layout isn't being used in my presentation yet, but I'd like to customize it to create a new layout that I can use. I think I'd like to add a bold color block behind the title text to make it really stand out. I'll start by going to the Insert tab, then selecting the Shapes command. And then just drawing my shape right across the text here. Then, to make the text visible again, I'll right-click and select Send to Back. To make the title a little easier to read, I'm going to make it white. And since we have a lot of red on this slide now, I'm going to delete this shape by selecting it and pressing delete on my keyboard. Now let's find the layout we just edited. Click Close Master View. If I click the drop-down arrow on the new slide command, we can see the layout here. Just click to select it. Once you've got everything the way you want it, you may want to use the layouts in other projects. To do this, you'll need to save the theme. Just go to the Design tab, click the drop-down arrow in the Themes group, and click Save Current Theme. Then, just give your theme a name and save it. Now you can select this theme whenever you want to use these layouts.